Liberal Viewer presents.
So when the U.S. Supreme Court heard oral arguments last month on the constitutionality of the health care reform law that Congress passed in 2010, there were a lot of cable news pundits predicting the court would overturn the law based just on the questions from the nine justices on the court, as you can see, for example, from Fox News pundit and lawyer Megyn Kelly, who once covered the Supreme Court, but who now supposedly plays the role of a straight news anchor on Fox News, and who told her viewers that the questions the Supreme Court justices asked seemed to signal the way they would vote in this clip.
In a nutshell, here's how it went. The four liberal justices signaled today that they would likely favor the government's argument that the health care overhaul is constitutional. The four conservative justices seemed to be telegraphing that they are against the law, the individual mandate, the constitutionality of it. And just a short time ago, the very justice who is likely the critical swing vote signaling he may not be buying the government's argument either.
And even when Fox News anchor Greg Jarrett, who's also a lawyer, reminded Megyn Kelly what they teach lawyers in law school, that it's wrong and risky to draw conclusions from the questions judges ask during oral argument, Megyn Kelly actually doubled down on her punditry, as you can see here.
It is risky, but I have to tell you, I mean, I said this on the air yesterday, when I was there, every time I felt able to predict how they were going to vote, and I was never wrong. That's not because I had any great discerning abilities. But if you listen carefully, they do generally tip their hand if you know the case and you've read the briefs.
Now, guessing the outcome based on the questioning of judges during oral argument is just guessing, and Fox News viewers should not be misled otherwise, but the dire predictions of lawyers on cable news programs based on the oral arguments were not limited to Fox News, with some of the most negative reports coming on CNN from lawyer and pundit Jeffrey Toobin, who reacted to the judges' questions like this.
This was a train wreck for the Obama administration. This law looks like it's going to be struck down. I'm telling you, all of the predictions, including mine, that the justices would not have a problem with this law were wrong.
Well, at least CNN pundit Jeffrey Toobin there wasn't pretending to be a straight news anchor, but predicting a train wreck for health care reform just from oral argument is a little bit much, though not nearly as far as satirical conservative pundit Stephen Colbert took his analysis, as you can see in this clip.
Oh, train wreck is too kind. It was a train wreck that slammed into the Hindenburg, landed on the deck of the Titanic, and then sailed it to see John Carter.
Now, the reason the CNN pundit, the Fox News pundit pretending to be a straight news anchor, and the comedian pretending to be a conservative pundit all made such dire predictions about the fate of the health care reform law in the Supreme Court is because a surprising number of the fallacious arguments that Tea Party Republicans have been making against the law were repeated back by the conservative justices during oral argument, including the infamous broccoli analogy, which responds to the argument I made in my last video on this topic that virtually everyone ends up being a consumer of health care, so the government isn't forcing you to buy health care, but only regulating how you buy your health care and who ends up paying for it. The broccoli analogy responds by asking if everyone's need for food means the government can force you to buy broccoli, which isn't a very good analogy, but that didn't stop the broccoli drinking game that MSNBC pundit Rachel Maddow described here.
Dahlia Lithwick said on our air last night that she would be playing a broccoli drinking game at the Supreme Court today, where every time somebody said broccoli in these arguments, you'd have to drink. So we will have to see what sort of shape Dahlia is in after broccoli was brought up 8 times in the oral arguments, just as she warned us it would.
Now, despite the prevalence of the broccoli argument at the Supreme Court, it's not a good analogy, and it's not even a good argument for limited government, as satirical conservative pundit Stephen Colbert pointed out in his own ironic way in this clip.
I mean, if they can tell us to buy health insurance, that completely destroys the idea of limited government. Because right now, all the government can do is tax me, draft me, put me in jail, or declare me an enemy combatant and then execute me without trial using a flying death bot. But making me eat broccoli? I think we'd all rather die from a preventable disease.
And Stephen Colbert and his guest Slate senior editor Emily Bazelon went on to give several ways that broccoli is unlike health insurance in this clip.
People aren't coming from Connecticut to Massachusetts not eating their broccoli, showing up, and then demanding that the people in the new state spend millions of dollars to deal with the fact that they haven't had their broccoli.
And if I don't buy broccoli, it doesn't raise the price of your broccoli.
Right.
And if we don't all buy into this national broccoli pool, it doesn't get rid of all broccoli eventually. And we aren't the only industrial country that does not provide universal broccoli care.
Right.
So the broccoli analogy is so silly that it's actually a little embarrassing it was mentioned 8 times at the Supreme Court, but Supreme Court justices like Anthony Kennedy and John Roberts will have more to be embarrassed about than just broccoli if they end up voting to overturn the health care reform law, as Dahlia Lithwick, Slate's reporter on legal issues, pointed out back on the Rachel Maddow show in this clip.
What happens in oral argument, particularly in a case like this, isn't the whole story, Rachel. What's going to happen in Friday at conference is going to be part of the story. And even more importantly, in looping back to your opening there, what the justices are thinking, or certainly justices like I think Anthony Kennedy and Chief Justice John Roberts are thinking, is how does this impact the court to hand down another 5-4 citizen United Bush v. Gore-like opinion in an election year. And I don't think it's just a slam dunk, certainly for those two justices, to pull the trigger on that.
And I agree with that analysis, and I'm sticking to the prediction I made in my previous video about the health care law being constitutional, because it would be an unprecedented display of partisanship for justices to ignore the court's prior decisions that defer to Congress when Congress regulates decisions that Congress rationally believes have a substantial effect on interstate commerce. To rule against health care reform, justices like Kennedy and Roberts would have to ignore Supreme Court rulings going back to at least the 1930s, which is why I also agree with the analysis of President Obama last week here.
We have not seen a court overturn a law that was passed by Congress on a economic issue like healthcare that I think most people would clearly consider commerce. A law like that has not been overturned at least since Lochner, right? So we're going back to the 30s, pre-New Deal. And the point I was making is that the Supreme Court is the final say on our Constitution and our laws, and all of us have to respect it. But it's precisely because of that extraordinary power that the court has traditionally exercised significant restraint and deference to our duly elected legislature, our Congress. And so the burden is on those who would overturn a law like this. Now, as I said, I expect the Supreme Court actually to recognize that and to abide by well-established precedents out there. I have enormous confidence that in looking at this law, not only is it constitutional, but that the court is going to exercise its jurisprudence carefully because of the profound power that our Supreme Court has.
So maybe President Obama is being naive there, and maybe I'm naive for thinking a majority of the Supreme Court will follow precedent rather than partisanship, but after decades of hearing conservatives decry judicial activism and claim judges should not substitute their own opinions for the decisions of Congress on these kind of economic issues, I just don't think the Supreme Court is going to hand down a decision more partisan than even the one that gave George W. Bush the presidency, but I want to know what you think. Will a majority of the justices of the Supreme Court choose precedent over partisanship and uphold the constitutionality of health care reform? And regarding the title of this video, is broccoli really like health insurance?
YouTube, you decide.